Working in Madagascar's most isolated corners is a real challenge, and this trip to film red ruff lemurs proved to be one of the hardest. For this shoot, cameraman John Brown and producer Ian Gray have been joined by expert tree climbers Tim and Pam Fogg. They will be responsible for getting John into the forest canopy where these rare lemurs live. The easiest way onto the Masoala Peninsula, a four-hour ride in a fast boat. The crew rendezvous with their local guides at a little-used research station on this isolated coast. They need to be entirely self-sufficient while working here.
That's the toilet. Nice.
Curious, lovely. Better than the huts outside.
Red ruff lemurs are endangered, and these forested mountains are their last refuge. It might seem like looking for a needle in a haystack, but the crew have a cunning plan.
Uphill all the way.
Red ruff lemurs love to eat fruit, so find a fruiting tree and the red ruffs shouldn't be too far behind.
Oh, this is a cruel hill. You just look up and it just goes on and on, up hundreds of metres. It's a brute.
Then, on the second day of searching, they get a lucky break.
That tree looks like it's loaded with fruits.
Oh, yeah.
Can't see any lemurs, though.
No.
It's a lovely tree, though.
It is. Those are definitely red ruffs, aren't they? Over there somewhere, I think.
This is encouraging. It's only the second day, and things are looking distinctly promising.
But we've leapt out finally. We found a big fruiting harami tree just over the ridge here, and there are red ruffs working in these trees. And the best thing is there's another tree next door to it, which we think we can get the platform into. We'll see what tomorrow brings.
Rain. Lots of it. And this is supposed to be the dry season. The tropical paradise is suddenly losing some of its glamour. Hoping the rain will soon pass, the crew heads off into the forest to rig the filming platform so that it's ready when the weather improves. But if anything, the rain is getting worse. The hardest part is getting a line up into the tree. This will be used to pull up a rope.
Yes!
And then haul up the filming platform and fix it in place. 30 metres up, this will put John level with the lemurs as they feed. By the end of a very wet day, the only camera still working is on a mobile phone. It's a bedraggled team that arrives back at camp.
Oh, dear.
Everything has been thoroughly soaked. The crucial thing now is to try and get the cameras dried out.
What's really annoying is you kind of know that the animals that we've come halfway around the world to film are probably doing exactly what we want them to be doing. Looking fantastic somewhere up a tree.
When rains find James,
All anyone can do is to be patient and hope for a change in the weather. After 8 long days, there's a small break in the clouds. So it's quickly back up the hill once again and onto the platform.
Well, this is day 8 of the shoot, and so far I've shot about 2 minutes of film, and it looks like there's another storm coming in across the bay that I can see.
As the storm breaks, being up a tree on a metal platform doesn't seem to be a good idea. Time for another hasty retreat.
So far, I'm not sure we're going to get what we need, but we'll just keep trying because, what else can we do?
Desperate times call for desperate measures. The key thing is to get rid of the condensation without melting the lens.
Day 9. It stopped raining. No, it hasn't. Still raining, and it rained all night, and we're going absolutely stir crazy.
I see why you married him.
I think all of us could do with seeing the sun and getting dry underwear on. That would make life a lot better.
Finally, the storm fronts blow through. It's time for one last slog back up to the platform.
So, after 10 days of trials and tribulations and a lot of rain, we finally got John up in the tree, so now all we need are the red ruffs to come and do their stuff. I can hear them calling already, so hopefully that's a good sign.
We're having a very strange meteorological phenomenon known as blue sky. And the lemurs have been in and feeding and sunbathing, and it's been just such a relief. So yeah, it's amazing what a difference the weather makes.